Oh, I haven't time to tick you in on her today.
But you said I could do something different today.
Yes, I did say that. But how about Sam that ticks you out? Thanks to something extra special planned.
What is it?
How would you like to take a trip to see the river, Caitlin? I can tell you all about it. In fact, I can show you.
What are you waiting for then? Let's go.
The Lochs Agency is here for protecting salmon and sea trout and the foil system. So the big river is very, very important, 1,300 square miles long. The Lochs Agency protects fish from poachers, protects fish from pollution, things like litter and rubbish from farms. We have several different types of fish in our aquarium. We have wrasse, we have pollock, we have trout, and we have rudd. They're all from different types of water, from salt water and from fresh water. We feed them 3 times a week. We feed them all sorts of things to make sure that they have a balanced diet.
So there's also a group of people who help anybody who comes up to the injured by the river. See that building? This is where the foil section rescue team are and where their boats are stored.
Foil Search and Rescue is a lifeboat that's on call all the time for anybody that falls under the river and needs help. The purpose is to be there as quick as we can to save someone's life. Foil Search and Rescue covers from Strabane to Limon Valley. Foil Search and Rescue is made up of everybody from the community that gives up free time to come and help anybody that they feel they can. They patrol the river 3 nights a week, Thursday, Friday and Saturday night, from 9 o'clock at night to 3 in the morning. They help anybody who may get into any dangers. And there's a 24-hour pager call that can be activated by the police if anybody is in immediate danger.
Right, Caitlin, there's one last place I want to take you. Are you ready?
A battle took place during World War II called the Battle of the Atlantic. Because of the river foil, ships from navies who were involved in this battle were able to be stationed in the city, bringing over 36,000 people with them. Several airfields and facilities, including a radio station, a ship repair base and storage yards, were then built to help the people win the battle. At the end of this war, many of the boats used were left in the city's harbour.
Are any boats still here?
Well, it happened a long time ago, so I don't think there's anything left here now. Anyway, I think I've told you enough about the river today. Did you have fun?